Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Historic District Commission meeting. It is Monday, May 17th, 2021, and it's 6:35 p.m. Pursuant to the open meeting law, any person may make an audio or video recording of this public meeting or may transmit the meeting through any medium. Attendees are therefore advised that such recordings or transmissions are being made, whether perceived or unperceived, by those present and are deemed acknowledged and permissible. Can I get a roll call, please?
Rick Mancini, present.
Yes.
Connie Soul,
present.
Jason Bouchard Naraki, present.
And Kristen Cantara Oliveira, present. And we do still have three open seats. All our members are present this evening. First up on the agenda, we have the minutes from 1/28/2020 to approve. Can I get a motion to approve the minutes?
I'll make a motion.
Okay, for?
For January 28, 2020, for the minutes.
Okay, I have a motion.
And I'll second that.
Yes. I have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Okay, next up we have the minutes from 7/21/2020. Can I get a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion to approve.
Okay, I have
7/21/2020.
Motion to approve the minutes. Can I get a second?
Second.
Motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. And last we have the minutes from 10/20/2020. Can I get a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes from October 20, 2020.
Okay, I have a motion to approve. Can I get a second?
I'll second.
Okay, a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Moving on, do we have any public input this evening? Okay. Moving on to new business. First up, I received a letter from Anna DaCosta at 491 High Street. Dear Chair Cantara Oliveira, I hope this letter finds you well. First and foremost, I would like to thank you, the Historic District Commission and board members, for giving me the opportunity to present my request on March 29, 2021, and granting me permission to move forward with my project. I would also like to thank Jason Bouchard Naraki for taking the time to research my home's history and seek out the architect. It's greatly appreciated. The following is addressed specifically to Richard Mancini and Connie Soul. It has taken me a while to fully digest what transpired at the Zoom meeting and express myself in a meaningful manner. I recognize and respect your passion in preserving the integrity and restoration of our beautiful neighborhood. However, the tone and delivery of your message could use a kinder voice, one with respect and professionalism instead of insult and condescend. To you, 491 High Street may just be another house associated with the 40C. However, it's a home to my family and I, one in which I saved from falling victim to a 2-4-6 family, or worse, a halfway house that unfortunately happens time and time again. Furthermore, I was questioned incessantly regarding my windows, which were not part of the scope of work presented and were installed in early 2014 prior to the establishment of the 40C, which occurred in 2015. I believe that we can do more for our neighborhood, which has been deemed valuable to the city by coming together in cleanup, beautification, hardscape improvements, tree planting, etc. May I suggest a welcome to the neighborhood packet with Historic District 40C guidelines, Preservation Society contact for outreach, restoration resources, and any other pertinent information be introduced to all new and existing residents to avoid unnecessary issues and offer a support system to the neighborhood. This letter is by no means meant to disparage your work and commitment. It is a friendly reminder that I, like you, are a part of the 40C with the same conviction and passion and want the best for our neighborhood, community, and the city as a whole. Sincerely, Anna P. DeCosta.
Would anybody like to respond?
It would be a disparaging remark if I said that I'm going to, after the ordeal we went through, that I just consider the source from which it comes.
Next up on our agenda, we have 527 Rock Street, and they are looking to strip and re-roof portions of the roof. So do I have anyone here?
Yes.
Oh, okay. If you want to come up to the microphone, you can have a seat. You can move the chair over and just tell us your name and address. Just sit at the microphone, please.
Yes, my name's Andrew Bockhorst. It's 527 Rock Street.
I have the look of the historic building.
Okay. So you are looking to strip and re-roof a portion of the roof?
Yeah, that's correct. It's, we've lived in that house since August of, actually going on 3 years now, I guess. And it's, this, actually just for this roof project was the first time that I've actually been up on the roof. There's a sort of a rubberized flat area, and the shingles there, the, most of the roof is still slate, the original slate, but there's a portion in sort of like at the top of the house that's very old shingle at this point, probably about 25 years old. It's all non-architectural, and several portions of the slate is missing, or the shingle's missing. And so we were getting actual leaking into the third floor of the house, so, which caused quite a bit of damage before we could, before I mitigated it. And I do have sort of a diagram. I'm not certain exactly how much information was submitted during the permit from the construction company, but I do have, I've got pictures on my phone, if you'd like to take a look at that. I've also got sort of a diagram of exactly where the portion of the roof is currently shingle, and that's the only part that's going to be stripped and replaced, just the old shingle to be replaced with new shingle.
Okay, yeah, that's what we didn't have the portion, like, we have photos of, it's this one.
Yeah, I thought we received photos.
It's in the packet that I gave you. It looks like this.
I know what it looks like, I just can't seem to.
Now, see, you have stuff in yours that I don't have, so are you looking at the same thing?
547 High?
No, 527.
I don't have that.
It looks like this.
Yeah, this is a little vague, I guess. The section that you want to re-shingle is.
Do you mind if I come and see what you have?
Sure.
Because I'm very curious about that. I spoke with the contractor a couple of days ago and asked if the material that was submitted.
It's not in color, though. Do you think it's in color?
604.
I don't have it in color.
But that's not my house.
That's the one.
527 is my place.
Oh, why am I on 604? Okay, my error, my friend. You're on 547?
No, 527 Rock Street.
Guess I don't have that. Oh, here we go.
Okay, yeah, that should be it. So, yes, I think that is the, yeah.
It's where there's a skylight, right?
Yeah, it's replacing the skylight as well.
So it appears here you have a skylight here?
Yeah.
And another skylight here?
That is a chimney.
And this is another chimney here?
Yeah.
Okay, so this skylight area is?
Well, this, actually, this is a better picture here.
Yes, it is.
So, yeah, this is the, everything here is slate. This is the flat rubber portion, skylight here, and this is the last bulge.
Okay.
This area with the star.
Yeah.
That isn't all that clear, I guess.
No, it's not.
Right. So, but anyway, that's just for clarification.
So this is what you want to redo, okay? And that's actually not visible from the street.
No, it might be visible from the backyard of the house behind it.
Exactly, but not from the street properties.
Correct.
Okay. All right, well, that's much better. I got an idea now. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Like I say, I've got photographs on my phone if anyone's interested.
So this is the section that's leaking, that's in rough shape?
No, right there.
Oh, I see.
The shingles blew off, and it's leaking into our third floor.
Okay.
We were able to do a kind of a rough rubber cement patch and tarp it, so there's no more leaking at the moment.
Oh, that's good.
Would like to get it fixed.
Yeah. Thank you.
So it's this section here?
Yes, that's all. And this is the, this is kind of what it looks like now. It's this section. It's leaking currently.
Okay.
And you can kind of see the shingle.
Yeah.
As it exists now, which is not great. That's just the asphalt.
So this is the street view here, and this is the back of that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see this part from the backyard, and I think the neighbors, the neighbors backyard behind us.
Yeah, but not from the front view from the street.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, because we were trying to figure, because we knew that some of it was slate, and so we didn't understand what you were replacing, because we thought the whole thing was slate.
It wasn't super clear. I think there was a star on the top of the house.
Oh, right, right there, but even then, it doesn't, we can't tell that, so.
There wasn't a lot of warning.
Yep.
So this is flat, this is on pitch, this is red area.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting, that's slate, and then the back was asphalt.
Yeah, it looks like it was probably, I'm thinking it was that part of the asphalt, the shingle, I'm assuming was replaced sometime. That's the flat rubber. There's a skylight here. And this looks across that way.
Okay.
It's the tarp area where it's leaking currently. And so we're just stripping all of that.
Perfect, that clarifies.
And please move that way.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so does anyone have any questions?
No, I think he did a great job explaining it, especially with your updated photos and stuff. I appreciate that.
Yeah, that definitely.
Okay, yeah, and if you'd like me to sort of compile this and email it to you just for archival reasons or whatever else, I'd be happy to do that.
No, there's no need.
Okay.
We have everything that we need, so.
And we're replacing. I'm sorry.
No.
So sorry.
No, go ahead.
So you're replacing shingles, four shingles.
Yeah.
What type of shingles are being placed? Architectural or?
Asphalt, Owens Coring Duration. I'm not a shingle guy, but that's my understanding. It's just that they're going to be dark slate colored.
It's going to match. Try and match the slate color.
Yeah, my understanding is that the color of the shingle is slate. So, we're going to try to match it as well as we can.
Okay.
Your home is beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. No, I have no issue.
No, I don't either.
You want a motion?
Sure.
All right, I'll make a motion that we accept this letter.
Okay. I have a motion.
Allow the proceed with the project.
Mm-hmm. I'll second that motion.
I have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. So I will, I'll get that letter to the building department, and I will send a copy to you as well.
Oh, great.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It makes a difference with that little extra photo.
I'll pass this along.
Thank you.
Okay, next up on the agenda, we have 604 Rock Street to strip and re-roof. And we do have someone here on Zoom for that. So if you could just tell us your name and address, please.
Hi, it's Marco Batran, and I think Alvaro is on as well as the contractor. Our address is, we're talking about 604 Rock Street, and our address is 305 Dudley Street in Boston.
Okay.
Alvaro, do you want me to proceed?
Hi, guys, yes, that's fine.
Okay, so we only purchased this property about 2 years ago, and about 9 months ago, we received some complaints. It was over the winter, really, that some tenants were getting water in their units on the upper floors. And we tried to just patch it up and cover the affected areas. When we went up there, we noticed that the roof is in fact very, very old, and a number of shingles had fallen off the roof. We hired a contractor a couple months ago to find shingles that looked as close as possible to the asphalt shingles currently on the building. And we selected shingles, and now we're filing an application. Unfortunately, we didn't understand that and I apologize, that's my mistake. We didn't know we had to come in front of the Historical Commission, so apologies for the backward process here. But we hired a contractor now to help us complete the project, strip the roof, put new membrane under the asphalt shingles, and put new asphalt shingles on. There are two units that have been getting water. We have the roof sort of tarped and patched as best as possible for the time being. We submitted an application. I don't know if you have it there through our property manager.
Yep, we do. We have okay, we have all the information.
The pictures and stuff?
Yep.
So we're not making any architectural changes or we're basically just replacing the older roof with a newer shingle, which hopefully will resemble the old one as closely as possible.
So you're just doing the back portion, that one area that's damaged, or?
No, we're doing the entire roof. It's asphalt. It's all asphalt shingle. There's a portion in the center that you can't see that's rubber.
Yep.
Just a rubber membrane. Everything's being replaced. The roof's in horrible condition. It was leaking on two different parts of the building.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually leaking when we bought it as well, but we were able to patch it. But when we really got up on the roof, we about a third of the shingles are missing. They've been blown off over time and storms, things like that. And
would you or your company consider maybe upgrading even the color, like instead of matching what is there, since you're doing the entire roof, just to complement the home a little bit more? You know, you don't have to match what's actually there, because what's actually there is not historically
accurate.
Yes, for lack of a better term.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I understand your need, and it's obviously a pretty emergent since you're getting water damage into the home.
Yeah.
But I didn't know if you'd consider looking at something different, you know, something perhaps, even if
darker.
It's an asphalt that is a dark one, you know.
Yeah. We actually did, I have in some stuff, work I do in Boston, I spoke to someone about it, and they suggested this color that's called Moore Black from CertainTeed.
Mm-hmm.
The color had faded. We think that something similar might have been in place a long time ago, although it obviously had faded to a light gray. But we have already purchased, and it's on site, all the asphalt shingle, but I do believe it's a, at least I'm not an architectural historical expert, but my friend thought it would be the appropriate shingle for that property. We did provide a couple pictures in the packet. It's called Moore Black. But unfortunately, because of the confusion we had with the contractor, and again, I take the blame, all of the shingle is already on site, but I'm hoping that you would find it very complimentary. It's a high-end architectural shingle as well.
This is what it looks like.
They are an architectural shingle?
That's
what,
is that what
I'm hearing?
Rick, I have a photo of it right here on the phone.
Yeah.
So which one is it?
It's the one at the top that goes across the top.
Okay. I got it up here?
Yep, that one up there.
Okay. Yep. Good.
good looking.
It's the nice.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Good choice.
Yeah.
Thank you. And, you know, we want the house to look nice, and we understand the historical area is my first project in that area, so I apologize for the mishap on the time.
I have a question that's not regarding the roof, but when you purchased the property, did you realize it was in a 40C? Was there any communication about that through your realtor, or just wondering if it's getting communicated?
No.
Okay.
No, I just knew it was called the historical area. You know, we love Fall River, we're there often, but I didn't know that there were special, I don't want to blame the broker or anything, I should have known better, but mm-hmm. I didn't know.
Well, actually, it is the realtor's responsibility to look at the deed on the property, because it would tell them, so.
Oh.
They needed to do their due diligence.
Yeah, they didn't do
you.
Their due diligence, yeah. Because it is the realtor that actually should be telling you that.
Okay. Well, I make a motion to approve a letter to be sent.
I'll second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second to approve a letter for re-roofing 604 Rock Street. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, so we will get that letter to you and to the building department as well, and you'll be able to continue. So.
Thank
and
you
I
so
just
much.
I echo their sentiments. It was a nice choice in shingle. It looks very nice.
Oh,
thank
very
you.
Happy for that. Thank you.
Excuse me, sorry. I have a quick question.
Oh, sure.
Oh, sure.
Is the building permit going to be mailed out, or is it something we pick up from the town hall?
Okay. When did they submit it?
I don't know.
How long ago?
They haven't. The letters.
No, I have the. No, but the building permit is right here.
Oh,
Frank has it. I think they were just waiting for
approval
from you guys. So
okay,
they're asking
like
if it's
it
going to be
I'll
mailed.
Let Frank know that.
Well, he wants to know if they're going to mail it or if they have to pick it up.
They normally.
That would probably be a question for the building department. Honestly.
No, I know. They can do either. They more so than not, they don't mail them.
Okay,
so
our clerk said more so than not, they don't mail them. It's usually the contractor picks it up, or the owner
okay.
comes to City Hall and picks it up from the building department.
Okay, we can arrange that. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Okay, and next up we have 547 High Street, and they are re-roofing. Oh, absolutely. Pull up a couple of chairs and have a seat.
Good evening.
Hi. Good evening.
Hi. If you could just tell us your name and address, please, for the record.
My name is William O'Brien.
And I'm Rita McGuire O'Brien.
And it's 547 High Street.
Okay. So you are looking to, you're doing the whole roof replacement?
The whole roof.
Okay.
We're removing asphalt shingle and putting an asphalt shingle, I believe, similar to the one this gentleman was just talking about.
Okay.
Certainty,
okay.
Landmark Pro, and the Moir Black, I believe it was.
Oh, okay. Everyone's going to have matching roofs.
I believe that was the color.
Look at this here. I don't remember it saying the color.
No.
I did not put the color on the notes. I didn't know that would be necessary.
The reason we're concerned, like that we talk about the color, is just so that it is more complementary to the home.
Right.
And you as well have a pretty amazing home.
Thank you. It's very similar. I mean, it's a dock, almost like a black, charcoal black kind of a mixture mm-hmm. of an on the architectural type of shingle. Mm-hmm. I think it was the same name that that gentleman just mentioned. Okay. I'm not 100% sure. It's, right, I have the brochure and it shows it with that mauve black, but it does not mention the actual color in our quote from the contractor.
But it's the same, it's Certainty that...
It's Certainty Landmark Pro.
Is that a photo of the shingle style and type?
Yes.
This one, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And what color? Just yeah. It says the mauve black as well. It's the same one. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh yeah. Okay. Thank
you. Okay. I went with that too because it's one of the few colors in the side color.
Yeah, that's true. It's one of the few colors also that is readily available. A lot of supplies are limited right now with
the
contractor supplies. But it's like I said, just taking down asphalt and putting asphalt up. The existing roof was put up in 1995, and we also have had shingles blow off and water damage come into the house. It's been patched, but Ken Pacheco, the contractor, when he looked at it and did the patching, he said, you need a new roof.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. Yeah, it's been a rough winter and spring, actually, with the wind and the rain. It's been tough up on the hill like that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was during that December, January, where we had about 3 weeks of heavy winds and rainstorms that the mm-hmm. damage occurred.
Yes. When did you purchase the home? This is just a side note.
1988.
Okay. So,
any other questions?
No.
I don't have any.
I don't have any.
I'll make a motion. Actually, Rick.
Rick, do you have any questions or?
No.
No,
I'm fine.
I'll make a motion to approve. To give a letter of approval.
I'll second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second to give a letter of approval. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. So I'll get a copy of the letter to the building department and to you as well to do the roof.
Okay. Mr. Pacheco said that he would come into the building department mm-hmm. to pick the letter up.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Coming down and presenting. It makes it a lot easier for us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So next up on the agenda, local historic district preservation design guidelines. So I know, Connie, did you want to say anything about, I know Dominique introduced herself, so if you have anything else you want to add, because I know you met with her.
Yeah, trying to think. She pretty much, when we met, she just was letting us know she was going to walk the neighborhood. She wanted to know if there was any concerns about her walking around with a camera, if anyone was going to say anything. But
we do it all the time.
Well, we do it, and the schools do it, and, you know, so. So she wanted to get a good feel for the area, for the culture, and then she's going to be doing her homework and getting back to us, basically. She was very complimentary of the area, after she did her walk. Like she said, she was able to identify, concerns that we might want to address that she'll take up with us. It's exciting. It's great that CPC is funding this, and it's an exciting, project. And how nice is it going to be to have pictures and explanations and recommendations to homeowners? And it's going to be a great thing.
It will. It'll be very helpful.
It will, and it's great. I mean, it's a great resource for us to use, but. It's going to be so much nicer for us to be able to refer people to the guidelines because it's going to make it easier for them ultimately.
And she said,
they're going to understand better.
She said other towns that she has done this for, cities and towns, that they actually use it even outside of the historic district just as guidelines so people understand what actually,
right.
Why you need a proportion size window versus when you replace a window and you shrink it down, why it doesn't look appropriate and changes the character of your home. She talked about how replacement windows don't last. They're not, the answer that salesmen.
We have them in my house,
and
they're awful because they were there when we bought the house, and they're awful.
Yes, so. And like in the house that the Dr. Fisk house here, we're restoring windows that are practically 150 years old and then some, and they're working. And so, the replacements, just like she said,
Well, it's
changed the character. And
right.
So it will be great if we can actually use this throughout the city when homeowners are looking for guidance and what to do.
There are a lot of other properties in the city, a lot of homes in the city that just are not in the district. And these people love their properties just as much, and they restore them.
Yes.
You know, they want to do right by the properties just as much. It's just they just don't happen to be in the district, and I think that a lot of people's going to appreciate it. So.
Yeah. And I mean, and especially with they're using our current local historic district in the event that can add to, expand the district or down the line or create new districts down the line, then we'll have this resource. And a lot of, as you mentioned, schools using, going through the neighborhood, taking photos. I mean, I had numerous site visits when I was a preservation student at Roger Williams here in Fall River. And not just that, but even there's a long time summer school through University of Virginia. It's the Vernacular Architectural Society. It's always held in Newport every summer, and it's all these architectural historians that are in school learning to do all this, and they use that neighborhood to look at their architectural examples. And aside from being in Newport, so it's great. It's an absolutely fantastic example of a wide range of architectural styles.
I had read somewhere, I can't remember where, but that the gingerbread house on Rock Street is the most photographed house in the city of Fall River.
I believe
read it somewhere as well.
Yeah.
So. Actually, I think the old website, the old Fall River website, had a picture of the house.
Oh, wait, the city website?
Yes, yes. Yeah, I remember seeing it. It was kind of funny.
Very photogenic.
It is.
It really is. But can you imagine if they were to change, some of the real characteristics and put in things that don't belong there? It wouldn't look the same.
That's true.
So, and I think too, people don't always understand proportion and why you need it, and especially with building codes where now the railings have to be a certain level, but people don't understand that in the historic district they don't have to be that level and why it takes away from the look of the front of the house when you have a railing that's too high and things like that. So I really can't wait for the guidelines to be done.
Yeah, it's exciting, I think.
And it'll be free. It'll be free to anybody in the city.
I know.
Public to use. So.
Yeah, Good stuff.
Yes.
And I think the beginning of it, she showed us the Newton one that we refer to frequently in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. She had
I love
that
Portsmouth.
One, I know. She had that one handy, and it explains, it educates you a little bit in the front of the whys and why nots. So it's nice as well, because when you have a rationale, you understand it better.
Mm-hmm. So, anything else?
No.
Okay, I just have one thing for open discussion, and it was actually from Anna's letter that she sent, where she actually had made the suggestion of sort of a welcoming packet. And I mean, I don't know how feasible a welcoming packet is, only because we don't know a lot of times when a property is even sold in the district. We're not notified. But I think that it would be a good idea if we did try and put something together, not so much a welcome packet, but maybe a list of resources where they can actually find resources until we have the guidelines, and just let them know the guidelines are coming. Maybe, like she had suggested, a contact in the Preservation Society, because I know that Preservation Society, you guys love to help out the homeowners and give different suggestions on things. And it's yeah. not a bad idea to send out to the homeowners so that they know, look, you can, you know, these are the steps you have to take regardless. Mm-hmm. And these are some resources that you can use.
Yeah. I do know that her husband worked on the Abbey, and I know that the owner of the Abbey, he's a great resource as well for, you know, the companies that he's used. I mean, I don't know if you've seen
Mr.
it.
Mr. Lombardi?
Yes.
Yeah.
If you've seen the work that he's done now on the sidewalk.
It's beautiful.
On the edge, it's like,
with the brick in the sidewalk,
yeah,
it looks beautiful.
He really pays a lot of attention to detail, and I know that Anna's Mr. Costa's husband actually has done work there. So, you know, so Andy's, Mr. Lombardi is another resource person. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I mean, it would be good to maybe compile some things and just.
Well, I'm not sure we can. I didn't even want to mention, but like the contractor they hired is a real, like, I would have recommended that contractor.
No, I don't mean specific.
Happy.
I don't mean
yeah.
for us to advocate, but if they go to the Preservation Society, the Preservation Society can certainly give them ideas.
Yeah, so that's what
of
we
who,
kind
and
of
that's,
do is guide them in that direction,
yeah,
I guess.
But I mean, if we even just send them something in the mail. I think we need to definitely remind them again, and maybe it's going to take doing it more than just once or twice and say, look, you really have to do this. It's not negotiable.
Mm-hmm.
And because then we run into problems like we did with the
I noticed that we didn't have it on the agenda, so I didn't want to bring it up, but I don't know why I didn't notice that it wasn't on the agenda when you sent it out, but like we didn't get to discuss the prospect.
Property on the corner.
Yeah, I think I just left that off accidentally. Like
yeah.
I wasn't when I was doing the thing, because there was sort of all these other ones that we were.
So as we're thinking of references and stuff like that, I was just thinking about like that particular house. I mean,
right.
I know that they were there from the beginning.
Right, and that's the thing.
Yeah, so
yeah.
It's not so much the lack of knowledge sometimes, that just, I don't know.
But I think we, at least if we do it, we can say, you know, we did our part now.
If you put that on the agenda for the next meeting, even the rapid meeting that we're going to put together.
Put what on the agenda?
The property on Prospect Street.
Okay.
So that we can discuss that. It's time that something gets taken care of there. And we can discuss the do's and don'ts, which direction we should go in.
Okay. Just a quick question for Carrie. We didn't receive any correspondence from. And they did receive it because we got the receipt.
Right.
That, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So,
So we will, yeah, when we have the historical commission meeting, we can have a district commission meeting as well. And we'll just, there probably won't be much on the agenda unless we get more requests in the meantime, but we'll have that on there.
Good.
Okay, so our next meeting is scheduled tentatively for Tuesday, June 15th at 6:30, but we will notify the public if that is going to change because we are going to try and schedule something sooner than that. So with that said, can I get a motion to adjourn?
A motion to adjourn.
Okay, I have a motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Thank you, everyone, and have a good night.